Thank you, Chairman. I'm not going to go through what I said previously, because everything I said previously relates to this. I think you read one of these applications and you read all three of them. The issues, the problems, the solutions, or lack of them, are all there, so there's no point in going through it all again. But just to highlight one or two things, I've been thinking about this actually, and I just wonder that it's so staggering that Hampshire County Council have not come up with anything other than giving you money. Is there a subliminal message in here somewhere that they're saying there is actually nothing we can do? Because I'm just staggered that they haven't come forward with something anyway. That's an opinion. Looking more so with this, anything south of Greenaway Lane falls in the Hookley Wasash catchment area. So we've got 140 homes, and by their formula, 25% of those 35 children are going to be seeking a school place somewhere, and it's not going to be in the Hookley Wasash Academy. So once again, it would be rather nice to get some indication from the authority as to which direction these children are going. Are we bussing them out into Fareham or Whiteley or somewhere? Are we going to build new classrooms somewhere? What are we going to do? But again, silence on it. And I think similar to that Councillor Cartwright has said, that with the master plan here, we did discuss with officers a while ago that in the event of any of these going ahead, we needed to manage it if these were to go ahead. And we would look at the emphasis being on entrance through Loxwood Road rather than Brook Lane. But we're already here, possibly approving three applications with three entrances all onto Brook Lane. And you know, my understanding is that this is about outline permission with site entrances. And once we've approved those, we're stuck with them. So every application that comes forward, we're tying our hands more as to the opportunity for moving them onto Loxwood Road, which of course would lessen the pressure on Brook Lane and the Brookfield element of, on Barnes Lane, the Brookfield element of Brook Lane. But it would send them up the bypass, which is a 40 mile an hour speed limit, no direct school. So that's surely got to be the best way. In the event of these going ahead of directing traffic, Loxwood Road and up there to Brook Lane, to Bridge Road, rather than the other bit of Brook Lane, past Brookfield School and at Barnes Lane. But we just seem to, with each of these, with access being onto Brook Lane, we're tying our hands more. So that is a worry. And also, it isn't anything to do with this application, but I will say, because we're not on reserve matters, but of course our master plan here indicates that the site, south of the site, two junior football pitches and associated car parking. Now, we do hope that Bargate, or it's possibly Langdon Partners, the one that we're not hearing today, have bought into that concept, because that's going to take a bit of a chunk away from the potential building plan. But again, that's not for today, that's for reserve matters, I guess. But other than that, I stand by the comments that I made in my previous talk for the first day. Thank you, Chairman.
Thank you, Chairman. I also don't want to repeat for the sake of order. I think it's this application overall anyway. But just some comments relating to some of the deputation we just heard. It's just probably worthwhile reminding ourselves that we need greenfield sites for much of our new housing requirement. That's a fact, and it's not a choice. And in fact, if you think back, our existing current approved borough plan, the new housing requirement identified in that was 100% greenfield land, and that was in Wellborn, and that remains the case. And if you go to the plan before that, most of the proposed housing was on greenfield land in the Western Wall. So it's fairly common whenever we have a new borough plan that almost by definition, if we have a new housing requirement, we are looking for new greenfield sites. The draft plan we've got at the moment puts as much as we possibly can into the town centre, we agreed, and suggests we'll be somewhere in the region of 1,000 houses coming through by a windfall, which are on brownfield sites. But the majority of new housing needs, by definition, will come out of greenfield sites. The 5-year housing land supply, as I understand it, is a continuing calculation. So to take up the point earlier in terms of what will actually be delivered, this is a continuing calculation, and at every stage we do a new calculation. In effect, the base starting point is what have we delivered? Then we add to that what's recently been approved, and then we see what the shortfall is. So, you know, if we don't get deliveries coming through, the outstanding requirement will increase, and that could well be an issue for us. In terms of the numbers and the proportionality, that proportionality statement, as I understand it, and correct me if I'm wrong, looking here at the head of development here, that proportionality relates to the overall need across the entire borough. It's not broken down on a ward by ward basis. It's, are the numbers that we're approving proportional to the total numbers needed and like to be delivered in the next 5-year period? And I think it was Mr. Thomas. I think, Mr. Thomas, although we understand totally what you're saying and the policies you're referring to, all the policies you bring up, you have actually missed the fundamental point that many or most of our current policies are now overridden by the basic need to provide housing. And the key considerations for us fall into the NBBF guidelines and SP 40, and the other elements are very much subsidiary to those two overriding considerations. The police statements, I think it's unfortunate where the police do comment these days on any applications. They tend these days to object to anything that might lead to them needing to put some resource into it. So the pathways through parks or that, there is a natural tendency to object because they may have to carry out some monitoring and checking. And that tends to be a standard objection. Although, I must admit, within this, they do make some good suggestions in terms of keeping away from hidden areas that we can possibly avoid it. And actually, I would concur totally with Councillor Cartwright that highways will not have solutions to avoid all adverse impacts. The best they will have is the suggestions in terms of how they might be able to reduce the totality of the impact. But 700 new houses must bring with it more roads, more cars on the roads, and more impact. We totally agree in that situation. And education, the county are engaged in some very detailed planning and considerations on education requirements. Once again, it is not unreasonable at this stage of any application request not to have the detail of all those requirements in front of us. In fact, just by and by, the county are so confident in the approach they take for education planning that they've actually agreed to provide speakers for Wasatch Residents Association meeting in April, and they will go through and review the approach they've taken. And I'm sure they will expect detailed questions about what the impact of these houses will be, so that they are prepared to do that. And then finally, dysfunction. We've heard a number of comments today about the Strawberry Fields development, and I understand and totally accept that we were unhappy with the design of that. But in terms of the numbers and comparison of densities, as it is adjacent, it's not at all unreasonable to consider the adjacency of that in terms of density. And yes, I guess as we look forward, as we project forward, increased housing within Fareham is going to lead to increased densities and coalescence of greenfield sites, which isn't necessarily desirable. Thanks.
Am I the only person here, for sure, who actually read this report, because we've had it twice now, on page 42 and page 64, DSP 40, where can we demonstrate that the council does not have a 5-year land supply for housing against the requirements of the core strategy? Additional housing sites outside the urban area may be permitted where they meet all of the following criteria. where they meet all of the following criteria. So in other words, sites cannot be allocated unless they meet all of the criteria. And I suggest to you, both the previous and this one, maybe another one, do not meet all the criteria. One of the criteria is the proposal must have ITER susceptible to environment, community, or traffic implications. Now, leaving that aside, I'm going to be very unpopular here, will be lynched on the way out. When I say this, much of our traffic problems are in fact self-inflicted by people who choose to commute. I've always lived within 10 minutes walk of my work, so I could go home to lunch and be in my garden by hours before the afternoon. Other people choose to commute, and that adds to the problem. And I wonder, Chairman, how many people here this evening came by bus as I did. Oh, well done, excellent, my friends, excellent. And the final point I would say, to offend someone else, the deputy agent said, why would we not build when we bought the land? Well, a long time ago I had a degree in economics, and the answer is, we don't build because we wait, we sit on the land, we land bank, and wait till the price of the land goes up.
Chairman, if I could just try and answer the point specifically raised by Councillor Davies on DSP 40. It is a complicated issue, so let me have a go and see if I can try and help. But you are obliged to apply the tilted balance, the starting point being permission, granting permission, unless there are substantial reasons that weigh against granting it effectively. So even if it doesn't comply in your mind, in full with DSP 40, you're still required to undo that test. So you could conclude that it doesn't accord with the CCD approved plans, adopted local plans, it doesn't apply with DSP 40, but even then you've still got to go on to the tilted balance. Yeah. Just to make that point absolutely clear. So it is possible members could judge that it doesn't meet all with DSP 40, but still conclude it should be granted.
And of course, my rock and hard place scenario, if you read the Highlands comment, which is what Councillor Davies was saying about traffic implications. In relation to traffic and highways, now submitted documents to the Civil Highway Authority were satisfied access is acceptable and everything else can be mitigated basically. So, I mean, you know, if you go to an appeal and you base it on the little one in the 14 that you were talking about, an inspector would say, well, where's the highway problems? They are mitigated and the Hampshire County Council are satisfied with them, so it doesn't apply. Any others? Councillor Fanning.
Chair, I think I'll go back to Councillor Davis's other remark, I think, is why we're here. I think a quick overview would be to delegate this all to officers, quite honestly. I'm sitting here now, and I'm only arguing about 5-year landscape, but what I cannot see is an end date to all this. Every application that's coming forward, now I've got, no, I'm counselor for Orchester, as yourself, and well, we've got development coming up there shortly, and people, residents of Orchester or Huntley or everybody else, looking in and listening to this afternoon, we'll be asking the question, what's the point? What is the point of all this? And I'll go back to what I just said. Let's delegate a whole lot to officers and let them go with it. Because I think at the end of the day, people, the public have a right to be heard. And at the moment, their wishes and their thoughts are being totally ignored. Thanks so much.
Yes, public consultation is important, but at the end of the day, we have to choose sites. And on the basis of your going on, and I made this point when you came as a non-councillor to the one of the meetings to do a world war, you completely insist all the time that we don't need it, it can go somewhere else. And the other question I put to you then was,
Where's somewhere else, and where are those people somewhere else who won't be objecting violently to not wanting not just their share, but our share? And you'll come back up to them. You can't answer it.
Yes, I can answer it. It's quite simple, really. We are at the moment going through a local plan review. That plan, that the evidence behind that local plan review is not, has not gone through its proper channels. It can be still be challenged. Legally, at the end of the day, a lawyer or a developer can take that to a legal challenge. We have none from part of our process. And part of that process is to look at sites. And how many times, as the Legal Council said when we were going through the consultation, these sites are not in concrete. He put us in blocking, it could be changed. Now at the moment, we're just simply applying or accepting sites. And that actually makes a mockery of the draft local plan.
Well again, Councillor, well again, we've got to accept the tilted balance approach the government set out. Without applying the tilted balance and looking at it, we have to give permission for these sites, whether we like it or not. And I wouldn't suggest in 1 minute there's any councillor around this table actually likes all what's going on, but that is a government requirement. And in order to do anything different, we would lose an appeal and face huge costs, and they still have their permission to build.
So why are we here?
Why are we here?
The question is, Jim, why are we here? We've been here now since 2:30. And why are we here? Councillor Davis said.
Right, anyway.
Yes, I'd just like to make a comment, and I might be wrong. We have to determine planning applications to put before us. It's a legal requirement. And we have to determine them in so many weeks. If not, we can be legally challenged, I understand it, for non-determination. Is that right?
That's
correct. So hence, we have these applications before us. And regardless of whether there's a draft local plan, as I understand it, we have no option. We have to determine them. It is the rules and regulations, whether you like it or whether you don't like it. I don't like it, but we have to do it. The other point that you make about land supply, if in these first 5 years or 2 or 3 years we manage to build enough houses, and it means the following year, the numbers won't go up, they're out of state, so they will drop a bit. Planning is a nightmare. For us to sit here and determine applications on behalf of residents does not sit easily on our shoulders when we don't like it. We do not do it easily. We have to do it. And as I said before, I have every sympathy, but in my mind there is no option but to accept this recommendation.
Any other member?
Yeah, we are here to discuss this, and we're here so that the residents can have their say. They've had their say, they might not like what we've agreed, but at least if they've had their say. If they lived in Eastleigh, they wouldn't even have a say. So I think the firm has done very well, and as much as they may not like what we have to do, we have to do it.
Chairman, would it be useful if what's happened in Eastleigh could be explained, because it could happen to us that if we don't tell me that it's then the government would walk in and do it for us?
You're not correcting what you say. You're not correcting what you say. They had none planning and handed out slices all over the places in one month. Right.
Mr. Chair, just one question regarding the question I actually asked in the last application. Council requested £300,000 to £630,000 from £1.1 million. Am I right to say that we have to wait to reserve matters before we know whether funds are coming forward?
Oh, that's
Chairman, let me secure for the section. Well, it's legally part of this commission with members of the wrong end. Those figures are agreed now.
For the members of the public, the total of highway contributions from these three sites is 1.48 million. Now, it seems, I suppose, in terms of highway improvements, that's small potatoes, but it's aimed at four junctions from where it's called, isn't it?
Yes.
So there will be junction improvement, and I noticed people talking about traffic lights, and we don't know exactly what they're doing, but that's quite a large sum of money, just the highway improvements. It won't happen immediately around the site, but it will allow access out of those sites onto the main thoroughfares, the main roads. Right. Right, we need to amend item 3 again, don't we? So what I need is proposal and a second of the game. Proposed by Councillor Mrs. Hockley, seconded by Councillor Evans. Those in favour of that one, consent, please show. And those against? Five, four?
Yep.
So that application is approved.